first thing you want to do is take a foundation and mix it with black and white face paint, and you want it to kind of be a palish gray color. Taking some black, you are going to mix this with your current face color just to create a darker gray color, and this is going to be for contouring. You're going to want to set your entire face with a translucent powder just to keep it a little bit more matte. Taking this NYX Primal Colors eyeshadow in the color Hot Black, I'm going to be using this for my contouring, but very lightly. I'm going to be priming my lids as well as underneath my eyes because I will be applying shadow underneath my eyes as well. I'm going to be using my Etude palette by Saucebox, and I'm going to be taking this burgundy color, and I'm going to kind of make a circle all around my eye. I'm going to be taking this ColourPop Cosmetics eyeshadow in the color Krinkle, and I'm going to apply a little bit on my lids. But my main color I'm going to be using is this color right here in the color Bay. Oh, it's the most beautiful color. It's absolutely magical. So I'm gonna go pretty crazy with this color, consistently using it throughout the tutorial, but I'm going to focus on the inner part of my eyes. For my eyebrows, I kind of wanted to create a cool gradient from black to gray. So I'm just going to start with black on the bottom and build it up with some of my foundation color and just use a spoolie to blend the black and gray together, creating a cool ombre effect. For my lips, I'm going to be taking my MAC lip liner in the color Night Moth, and I'm going to kind of create these 1920s tiny little lips, or doll lips, if you may. For my lipstick, I'm taking MAC lipstick in the color Sin and applying this over my lip liner. And to finish off the lips, I'm taking this gorgeous Gerard's Cosmetics lip gloss in the color Seduction. Taking my Saucebox palette, I'm going to be taking this black color and just going underneath my eyes, kind of creating a little smoky look. At this point, I had applied my false lashes when my left eye started to uncontrollably tear up and water, ruining my makeup and not keeping my lashes on. So I actually had to take these lashes off and apply new ones later, which throughout the video still would not stay on. So by the time I was done, I was just so fed up with the lashes. I was so upset because I really, really like this look. So please bear with me. This is called The Crying Gypsy for a reason. True story, guys. True story. Crying and makeup just don't mix. But moving on. Next, I'm going to be taking this Chaos Makeup Artist highlight in the color Striking. And this is a really, really pretty highlight. This is going to go on the outer lower part of my eye and down the bridge of my nose. Trying my second time with these lashes, I'm going to be applying those, but again, because my eyes were watering so bad, I could not get these lashes to stay on properly, so please excuse the lash monstrosity. I'm going to be taking this Shop Violet Voss glitter, and this is in the color Betsy. And I'm going to be mixing it with their glitter glue on the back of my palette and then applying it with a brush where I kind of applied the highlight. And I'm going to also draw some little crying tears of glitter. This was inspired by actually having watery eyes throughout this entire video. So yes, it was an inspired look. I'm going to add a little bit of black to the insides of my eyes. I decided to draw a cute little heart mold. And to finish this look, I'm going to be taking the city color Be Matte blush in Fresh Melon and applying that to my cheeks.